My name is Saddam Ali. I am 20 years old. I live in Brooklyn, New York. I am a 2008 Olympian. I was the first Arab American to represent the United States in the Olympics. I'm Arab American. My mom and dad were born in Sana'a, Yemen. I was born and raised in Brooklyn, New York. What made me want to start boxing is when I was little, about 6, 7 years old, I was watching Prince Nassim fight all the time, and I love how he fights. He's also Yemeni, and he inspired me to start boxing. And from there, my dad took me to the gym after school every day. I was working harder and harder, got better and better, and that was just my sport. I've been training and fighting since I was 8 years old. Now I'm 20. I've been through many, many tournaments and learned a lot. It's not hard. It's blood, sweat, and tears. And I made it as an amateur to the Olympics. And now I'm pro, and I'm 2-0 with 2 knockouts. And I'm looking forward to be the best out there, inshallah. Making it on the Olympic team, I was very happy. It was very hard. I had to work very hard every day before competing. So I was fighting against the best at my weight there. And I had to prove that I'm number one so I can go and fight in China. And the last person to make it on the Olympic team from New York was in 1988. So, and also being the first Arab American representing was a very big shock to a lot of people. Me being an Arab American, a lot of people didn't think I would be able to do it. But after all the hard work, it all paid off. I was very happy, the family was happy, everybody, all the fans, all the supporters were happy for me, and that's it. Being the Olympian for USA, it wasn't over yet. I still had to qualify myself to fight in the Olympics. So I fought against other countries, which was Venezuela, and I won the first day, and then fought the second day against Argentina and stopped him in the third round, which qualified me for the Olympics. It was another big, shocking, very great feeling, me making it there, and I was very happy about that. Fighting in the Olympics, it felt great. Not only I was representing USA, I was also representing all the Arabs around the world. It felt real good, but it didn't go as how I wanted. The way they were scoring and the way that the punches were, it wasn't the style of boxing that I was used to. I could have did better. There's things I could have changed, but it just doesn't always happen like that. So that's how it went there. I lost the first round, and it's okay. Just come again next time. But even in the Olympics, which I was shooting for the gold, which I didn't get, I'm still proud of myself for making it to the Olympics. That's the highest thing you can do as an amateur. So now we're moving on to turning pro. I turned pro. I had my first fight. It was a first round knockout. I had my second fight. It was a second round knockout. So I'm moving. I'm climbing the ladder, and I'm trying to get up to being just up top. Training for boxing is not easy. You have to train every day, but the only day you get off is Sunday. That's your relaxed day, and sometimes you even have to run on that day. So Monday through Saturday, I'm working real hard. I'm waking up around 11 in the morning. I'm going to the gym. I'm working out real hard. I'm also running at the same time. If I don't run at the gym, I run later on at night. It's just the same thing every day. I got to work out every day, and it's just the hard work pays off. It's either you want it or you don't. And going to school and training for boxing, it makes it even harder because I have no time to myself. All it is schoolwork and going to the gym. I wake up in the morning and I go to school. Right after school, I get maybe a 2-hour rest and then I go straight to the gym. After coming home from the gym, it's either I run on my treadmill downstairs in my basement or I go to the track. And then after that, I even got homework that I got to do to finish up from school. So I have to keep both of it together. It's very hard. It's something not easy to do. But it's either if you want it or you don't. And also my father, he's what put everything together. If it wasn't for him, boxing wouldn't be me. I'll probably just just be do something else. Maybe I'll be playing basketball. Maybe I won't be who I am right now. I mean, he takes me to the gym anytime I need to go. It's whatever I need. He pays for trips for me to go to fights. And when you do things like that, it makes a person better. I love him. He helped me do what I could do. If it wasn't for him, I wouldn't be here right now.
Assalamu alaikum. It's me, Mahmoud Ali, Abu Saddam. And from the age of 4 years old, I make sure he does the right things, go to school, and train boxing. Make sure you respect people. I'm his father, not only his father, I am also his friend. So whenever he boxes and don't do what he's supposed to do or fall behind, I always tell him he'll do better the next time. And that's what gave him the courage and the more experience to reach the level he's in today. And with all his fights that he's been through, I didn't miss no fights at all. And I think while he's fighting in the ring, when he gets hit, I'm getting hit. And I worry more than he does. So all these years that I've been with him and making sure he does the right thing, it's been great. An accomplishment that he's did in the amateurs, being the first in 20 years from New York and the first Arab American to represent the United States in the Olympic Games and in sports, is I'm very, very proud of him. I love him, and it's a gift that at the highest level that he got what he got.
Why did I choose boxing instead of any other sport? I'm very athletic. I play other sports. I play basketball, I play football, tennis, any sport you throw at me, I can do. But boxing is just, you just have that feeling. When you're playing a sport, you know if that's yours. Boxing is what I'm good in. Boxing is what I get the victory from. And that's just a sport that I love. I love doing. My goal within boxing right now is to be one of the world champions in the world, similar to Prince Nassim Hamed, what he did, things he did to his personality, things he did with Arabs all around the world, how they supported him. A lot of people loved him, and I just want to be a world champion and also be respected at the same time. That's my goal. I would like to say to anybody within the age of 20 or even younger, if you have a goal in your mind and you want to do something, it could be done. Me as a kid, I wanted to box. It's just something I wanted to do. Was I good when I first started? No, I wasn't good. It took a lot of work. It took practice. But at the end, it's going to pay off, just like it paid off for me. Thank you for hearing me and listening to me. Thank everybody for all the support. I really appreciate it.